number of things that people look for when they want to hit the beach, like white sand,
clear turquoise water,
exciting wildlife, and a healthy marine life,
spectacular land formations,
a sweeping sunrise,
and a stunning sunset.
That's right. Relaxation and adventure all kind of rolled into one.
And believe it or not, there is such a place, and it's called
El Nido. On this episode of Beached, we are doing a deep dive on the El Nido experience. What makes this place so special, and why it is so well known internationally.
El Nido is listed as one of the most gorgeous vacation destinations in the world on magazines, TV, online listicles, and many, many bucket lists.
Luckily, we live in the Philippines, where paradise is practically a hop, skip, and sometimes a short flight away. I'm Mark Nelson.
And I'm Christy McGarry.
And you're watching Beached.
A direct flight from Manila to Leo Airport in El Nido, Palawan, takes only an hour and 20 minutes.
El Nido is known for long strips of white sand, stunning sunsets, and a community focused on sustainability.
And another main attraction in El Nido is the Backwit Bay Archipelago. Dozens of islands and islets with treasures in the form of lagoons and caves, karst peaks, and majestic landscapes. Each an escape to behold and experience.
It is a pristine model for a resource-protected area. And many establishments here have been rewarded for their efforts to help keep El Nido protected.
And we're off to our first stop in this paradise, Lime Resort.
Look at this view.
Howdy,
yeah,
neighbor.
Yeah, it's not so bad.
What's up, neighbor?
Howdy, neighbor. This is beautiful.
Talk about a panoramic view.
El Nido is very well known for its fantastic vacation atmosphere, but it is also great for inspiring beautiful spaces and lifestyles.
And now we're about to get a glimpse of what it's like to live in a beautiful paradise like El Nido. We have with us today a dear friend, Levi Merique, who is a French-Filipino jeweler and now a resident of El Nido.
Yes, thank you. Welcome to El Nido. Welcome
nice to
back.
See you again.
Nice to see you too.
Long time no see. You
have a gorgeous home here now, but this isn't where you've always lived. Where are you originally from?
No, I was born and raised in Manila. I went to the French school there and then did my bachelor degree in Paris in luxury management. And then I moved back to Manila to be with my family and start my career. And eventually I just didn't feel very comfortable with the city life, or let's say I was tired of the city life. I wanted something a little bit more slow paced. I've been coming here for a very long time, actually. I've been coming for about more than 8 years. I came off for personal reasons, vacations with my friends, relax, and then met someone special who really gave me that little push.
But did you come across any challenges?
Yes, I mean, there are challenges every time you change your life. My biggest challenge was because of the pandemic. People think that it was easier to be here than the city, but it was also very hard in the sense where we weren't allowed to step out of our homes, we weren't allowed to step on the beach. And eventually the rules became less strict, so that was so nice to finally get to know people. So I'd say the transition took a bit longer.
Well, I know you love El Nido, but I have to ask, do you ever end up missing city life, Manila or Paris?
Yes, I mean, everyone gets island fever. It's just sometimes when you say that you're having a bad day, you can't just order a delivery or anything. Let's say I miss more of the convenience of being in the eye of in the city, but I don't necessarily miss the life in the city. It's harder to get stressed, if you know what I mean, because your environment plays such a big factor in your life. Island life is not for everyone, but in my opinion, it's just such, gives you so much more peace and tranquility to be surrounded by such so much beauty.
To breathe fresher air and to, I guess, experience the calming effects of just looking out on water.
Kudos to you for making that leap. I completely agree and understand why you did.
I guess our only other question is, do you need neighbors?
Always welcome for new. Always All happy right. to have new neighbors.
We are about to dive in to one of the most breathtaking marine reserves in the world. And we're going to immerse ourselves in the beautiful islands of the Bakwit Bay Archipelago. All this and more when Beach returns. This morning we're taking a speedboat into Bakwit Bay, which is made up of dozens of beautiful islands, each with its own treasures of stunning limestone cliffs and gorgeous lagoons.
We are not taking things slow. We're off to a quick start as we head to our first island on the list, Manilac Island.
All right, let's go.
You can opt to go island hopping in a catamaran or even yachting at a luxurious pace. But we're not wasting any time getting to one of the most gorgeous lagoons in Palawan.
We are going for the big one, the big lagoon of Manilac Island.
Now, of course, we've all been here before, but it's been a while for me. If you go through this narrow entrance and then it opens up into a large lagoon, if I remember correctly.
It goes up to 27 meters, and the shape of the depth is shaped like a reverse cone. So at the center of the lagoon is the deepest part. And with the help of the LGU, they've made sure to limit the amount of kayaks that go into the lagoon, avoid noise pollution, so no speedboats or boats in the lagoon either.
Deeper parts of the lagoon are an endless emerald green, but the view above water is just as breathtaking, with Palawan's limestone cliffs embracing you from all sides.
Adjacent to Big Lagoon is Small Lagoon, which is typically less crowded and just as majestic.
Small Lagoon is a beautiful, shallow cove, but there is nothing small about it. It's about 150 meters long and will require extra effort to get to. Watch your head as you kayak through little caves and crevices.
Even got to go through this very narrow and secret passageway, which is always one of my favorite secret gems.
Yeah, my first time going through that, and it was really, really tight. But once you're inside, it's a magical experience.
Shimizu Island is a great example of all the islands around El Nido where you've got this beautiful contrast of the dark karst limestone cliffs and the green foliage and the beautiful white sand beaches.
But Shimizu is particularly special for snorkeling. There's a current that brings you all the way through the passageway and around, and it's an awesome spot for island hoppers to stop for lunch. But today, we're going to be taking a dive with our dive master from Adventure Scuba, Sir Onat Ipak.
For the Shimizu, the real name is Paglugaban. We call it Shimizu because of what happened before, like 1985, the Japanese diver died inside. The body of one of the divers called named Shimizu, that's why they become Shimizu. So we are going to South Manilac, so that one's the most visiting dive site here in El Nido.
Rock and roll!
Rock and roll.
got to see up close and personal a lionfish in the flesh for the first time. I've always wanted to see one in person, and it didn't disappoint.
And it was quite chill. Mind us getting relatively close. Of course, you don't want to go in too close because they are quite poisonous.
Very. We also got to see a very friendly school of yellow snapper.
School of small barracuda.
Yes.
As well. And then that giant, giant pufferfish.
Holy cow. I never knew that they even got to that size. Must have been pretty old.
What a nice relaxing dive.
Relaxing? I thought it was exciting and awesome.
On the way to our next stop, you might think that you were just taken to see a cliffside with a crack in the wall, majestic from the outside. But yes, it's what's inside that we came all the way here for.
As you can see behind us is a beautiful cave, something that El Nido is very well known for.
It's called Cathedral Cave because once you go inside, or even the mouth of it, does resemble a cathedral. Super epic.
Approaching the entrance of the Cathedral Cave. Wow, it is a lot taller than it looks like from the boat.
This is unlike any cave I've been to. It is just so tall. It's narrow, but so incredibly tall. It really does feel like you're in a cathedral. The size is so impressive. The formations are stunning. You can see there's a hole up there.
Mm-hmm.
Some light.
And the colors in here are just beautiful too. You've got the lime, some clay, the gradient of the dark to the light greens. It's beautiful.
The last island on our tour is Pinangpuyutan Island, a massive rock with a small and quaint stretch called Ipil Beach. It's a quiet way to cap off the tour. And essentially, all the beach really needs is a shack and maybe a few coconut trees.
This island is beautiful. This little patch of beach right here. I can see why you like this place so much.
When you envision being stranded on a beautiful tropical island, this is kind of what you would want.
This island is extremely secluded. It feels private, like you have it all to yourself. And the water's always tranquil, perfect for a swim on a hot day.
Well, after a long day of island hopping, it's nice to enjoy a little bit of relaxation in a place like this.
We have this amazing infinity pool feature looking out into the ocean.
I've got to say, the view here at Maramegmeg is incredible. And if it's great down here, imagine what it's like from these villas. I love the way they're just sort of hanging off the cliff.
And I'm sure the higher you go, the better the vantage. And what's awesome about Maramegmeg Beach Club is that they're on one of the main beaches on the island that's accessible for swimming, cocktails, and great food.
Awesome. Now, from what I understand, this is actually called Maramegmeg Beach, and it is beautiful. You can see the islands of Bucket Bay from a distance, including Dilumakat Island, which is also called Helicopter Island because of its helicopter shape resting on the water. If you're going to be deserted on an island, then the islands around El Nido, I think, are pretty top on the list.
And what better way to end it than ending right here at Maramegmeg Beach.
That's right.
With a beautiful view of Helicopter Island in front of us, flat water, and the sunset.
You know what? The great thing I love about El Nido is that even with big resorts like Maramegmeg, it still has that real island El Nido feel to it.
It does. From locals and tourists alike, it's just one of those places that you'd want to call home.
Cheers to El Nido.
Cheers.
Now that we've seen the sights, we're going to visit the community of Tao Philippines and the Tao Beach Farm. Up next, here on Beached. Visiting El Nido is all about checking out its beautiful islands and, of course, El Nido proper. But sometimes just one day of island hopping isn't enough.
And aside from sights and wildlife, there are people who cultivate and coexist with this beautiful land, practically making them stewards of paradise.
Born out of a backpacker's sense of adventure, a lot of people seek out this place, Tao, Philippines.
We're visiting Tao Beach Farm to spend some time with the locals, as well as gain a deeper and more meaningful experience here in El Nido.
Well, Honey Rose Leona, thank you very much for joining us. You are a social worker for Tao Kalahi Foundation. Can you tell us a little bit about what it is that you guys do here?
Tao Kalahi Foundation has services and programs for education, livelihood, and health. In education, we have these scholarship programs for the youth. We are giving some school supplies to the centers. We're also putting up some school buildings in the islands, like for daycares, also in elementaries. Then in livelihood, we do have massage training. So we give trainings to the women so that they will not rely on their husband to come fishing. So they can also help their husband provide the basic needs of the family. Not only in El Nido, but in Palawan, we have a lot of coconut trees. We have trained women, out of families, to do virgin coconut oil. So out of the virgin coconut oil, they bring it in here, we buy it to them. Then we've also trained women to make soaps and shampoo. Now the products from virgin coconut oil is the soaps and shampoo that we're selling to our guests.
That's a lot.
It's a lot, yeah, it's a handful.
Whoa. We have a lot of resources here. So what we can do is to conserve them and use them for the development of our municipality.
Thank you so much for joining us. Now, we hear that you have been with Tao since you were a teenager. Tell us, how did that come about?
I was lucky to get a job from Tao. It's because of my brother, Ollie. He's also the one who started with Tao, the founder.
Why don't you tell us a little bit more about the tour packages and how that works, and explaining the homestay concept?
We do 5 days and 4 nights, either El Nido to Coron or Coron to El Nido. But that from 10 years ago, we do 5 days trip. So in a different base camp, living and camping in the remote island, we can offer a 2 nights camp staying and 2 nights in 3 days boat tour. And in the next season, we are offering the ultimate experience, like 2 days in 1 night experiencing our parao or the balatiks, and then 2 nights in 3 days by motorized boat like that, and then 2 nights staying in the camp.
Here with organic soap maker extraordinaire of Tao, Philippines, Ate Pai.
Hi,
Ate
Pai.
Hi, guys. We're going to make this one, coconut soap. Our base was coconut oil, so we're just going to make sure coconut oil.
That was VCO that you poured in. What is this?
This is the lye. So all of the soap has a lye.
You're lying.
So this is the caustic soda. Uh-huh. So okay. It is commonly called as lye. So this is the one who makes the soap harder.
Let me take.
All right, let's check out your baking skills.
I am actually a terrible baker.
No,
oh, okay. Don't whisk. No whisking. Just stirring.
Like I see. Yeah. You're a terrible baker.
Already making mistakes.
This obviously helps the community because it's giving back by buying the product from them. You came from the local community?
Yes.
All right. And how has being involved in Tao helped your family?
Tao makes a big difference.
Mm.
I can bring my child to school, so I can support my family. And then also for this job, we have our own house. We build our own house and then we buy our own land.
Wow.
Amazing.
Yes. So that was our investment. Here in Tao, they're not looking for your educational appointment or age. Okay. So this is the place where we are being trained, we are being molded, and so that's why this is the place where we learn everything.
Okay, is it soft and fluffy enough yet?
Yes.
All right, you can see the consistency is a little bit thicker.
Yep.
while you're mixing so he can get the
Mmm, oh my god.
Peppermint.
It smells like mint chocolate. I'm actually allergic to seafood, and calamansi mixed with sugar is actually a great antihistamine. So anyone out there that has allergies, try calamansi, a spoonful of calamansi and sugar.
How long does the entire process usually take?
If you are using the electric mixer, so it takes just 20 minutes.
So
and if you're using the Christi mixer,
yeah,
five am I
gonna
hours.
Be here for
5 hours.
All right, we'll see you later.
getting my workout in for the day.
Keep going.
All right.
Okay, is that looking close to ready now?
Yes. So the next step is the pouring process.
The pouring. Okay. All the way up?
Yes.
See, I'm a pro.
Not bad. Not bad. How long does it take?
It takes 24 hours.
Oh, okay. So we'll be here.
It's already creating a skin on the top. So that's, I guess, the beginning.
Yes.
Atipai, thank you so much. This is a skill I've always wanted to learn. And now I know that I need to bring Christi around to do all the stirring.
Yes.
But it's awesome, just a few simple ingredients.
Yeah, it's simple ingredients, and this is the great thing about making things organically. It's as simple as possible, it's as fresh as possible, using the best quality materials from just around the area. Good
thank
job.
You again, Atipai.
Coming up,
we take a little respite along Nakpan Beach and visit Angkla Beach Club for exciting activities on the shores of El Nido Bay.
Still so much to do here in El Nido when beach returns.
Now, I don't know about you, but when I imagine paradise, it looks a lot like Nakpan Beach.
The sand on Nakpan Beach is a gorgeous cream color that spans 4 kilometers. All you can see here are swaying coconut trees, clear water, some surfable waves, and a fishing village. Beach life at its simplest.
Now, there are a few resorts along this stretch, still offering the same kind of quiet that Nakpan Beach is known for. And Angkla Beach Resort and Boutique Hotel is no exception, offering luxurious hospitality within a stylishly simplistic setting.
The architecture here at Angkla Beach Club and Boutique Resort is one that blends elegantly with its natural surroundings, making it the best setting for some quiet time, either by yourself or with a little guidance.
Guided meditations and yoga classes are offered here at Angkla. You don't have to have previous experience in either. Novice and advanced practitioners are both welcome to enjoy the benefits of Angkla's location here in El Nido.
More to El Nido than just the beach.
That's right. These motorbikes are perfect for a short little beach ride. Shall we?
Let's go.
Being in the ocean, that is what going to the beach is all about.
Once we landed in El Nido, it was smooth sailing from there. We experienced the beach, the islands, the luxury, the people, and the beautiful things that this place has to offer.
And we're going to enjoy the water just this one last time on a parao at the ocean's pace.
Sailing on El Nido Bay, taking in all this beauty around me, it can be overwhelming, life-changing even. When I think of all the people we've met, why they moved here, how people live here, it really sticks with you. The deep sense of community and how you can't help but wonder if you can do that too.
Looking at all the land formations surrounding me, I just can't help but feel like I'm being hugged. And even if you don't decide to move here, it's certainly easy to say that El Nido feels like a second home. It's just one of those places you know you have to go back to. Well, sadly, it has come to that time of the show where we will soon be saying goodbye. But before we do that, it is time to give El Nido our beached ratings. We're going to kick things off with sand. And whilst El Nido is very well known for its beautiful limestone cliffs, did you know it's also got some pretty amazing beaches? I think my favorite was probably Nakpan Beach. It was my first time there, and it is spectacular. Just so wide and open, beautiful, powdery fine white sand, and a beautiful sunset view. And so for that reason, we are going to give El Nido 4 suns. 1, 2, 3, and 4.
Now, speaking of limestone cliffs that Mark mentioned, the scenery in El Nido is absolutely amazing. It's something that keeps me coming back time and time again. I mean, every time I've been island hopping, there's just so much to discover. The lagoons, the cliffs, the caves. And for that reason alone, we'll be giving El Nido a whopping 5 suns for scenery. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5.
Next up, we have sustainability. Now, the community in El Nido has always been at the forefront of sustainability efforts for the Philippines for probably a couple of decades already. And it really is evident as you go around. Check out the different places and the resorts. They're doing things like creating their own soaps, their own shampoos. We got to see what Tao was doing and all the incredible sustainability efforts that helped the community as well. And of course, going out to Angkla and seeing how they really incorporate those efforts with what they're producing, what they have in the rooms, and even things like glass water bottles, which used to be such a rarity, but is now spreading its way all over the Philippines. So, for those reasons, we are giving El Nido a whopping 4.5 suns for sustainability. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, and aha.
Now for stuff to do. There are so many things that you can choose from when you go to visit El Nido. Aside from the island hopping, which we had a fun doing, there's also so many beaches on different parts of the island that you can explore. You can have high-end luxury resorts, or you can stay somewhere sustainable like Tao. Whatever it is that you'd like, adventure or relaxing, El Nido has it for you. And for that reason, we'll be giving it 4.5 suns. 1, 2, 3, 4.5 suns.
And last but not least, we have the sea. El Nido is very well known for its ocean. The waters are crystal clear, and not only the ocean, but also the incredible lakes where you can go kayaking or swimming. There is just so much to see and do, and it is beautiful. And for that reason, we are going to give it 4.5 suns. 1, 2, 3, 4, and a half. And that means, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, carry the 5. Grand total of El Nido, well done. You have gotten 4.5 suns. That is an awesome result.
And well deserving. El Nido is a nesting ground for not only turtle hatchings and preserved wildlife, but also for inspiring ideas and aspirations for living.
That's right. And it's no wonder that nature created karst terrain, hidden lagoons, and beaches that just leave you pining for a longer vacation. So much so that travelers end up living here and, I don't know, creating a life in paradise.
El Nido is and will always be a lovely place and one of my favorite places to rekindle with nature and oneself. And I cannot wait to be back.
That's right. Me too. I'm Mark Nelson.
And I'm Christy McGarry. See you on our next episode of
Beached.